And we're back. Welcome all. New information this morning. The Des Moines Register, everybody, has their new poll out. First, the Democrats. Look at these numbers. Barack Obama now at 28. In October, he was at 22. Hillary Clinton, 25. In October, she was at 29. John Edwards has stayed the same, 23. Barack Obama, the new front runner in Iowa, according to the Des Moines Register. And here's how he did it amongst women. Look at this. 10-point increase from October amongst women. Hillary Clinton dropped 8 points. David Gregory, what do you make of it?
Well, I think that Barack Obama has sort of found his voice in this race. He's got the way to attack Hillary Clinton on her judgment, on her experience, on what people don't like about Hillary Clinton. And he's got a campaign style that's finally comfortable for him, and it's showing results. He's got a lot of money in advertising in Iowa. He is really moving around that state. He's forcing Hillary Clinton to have to beef up her forces there. So he is making a real race of it, and he's got some momentum behind him.
Gene Robinson?
Well, I think what's happened, the other thing that's happened is that the Clinton juggernaut, the inevitability factor, was really damaged by her performance in that debate. I guess it was in Philadelphia a few weeks ago. And that kind of gave people permission to look around. And Obama, he kind of deals with the experience question by being there, by having, you know, the more he's there, the more you hear him talk about national security and all the other issues that people care about, the less it seems relevant that perhaps he doesn't have as long an experience as others.
As they get to know him.
Yeah, right. It feels like he's been around for a while.
David Brody, you spent a lot of time in Iowa. What's your sense?
Well, a couple things. One, I think Barack Obama should be getting a thank you card from the John Edwards campaign any moment now. I mean, John Edwards has done the dirty work for Barack Obama, at least initially, and now Barack Obama obviously continuing on. I mean, the reality is Barack Obama spent a lot of time in Iowa. It has been a concerted effort. You can make the case that Hillary and others have been there too, but Barack Obama has gone ahead, especially from a staffing standpoint, is what you were talking about, David. He's been able to capitalize on that, and it's been like that since day one. It hasn't just been money, it's been staffing, it's been the blocking and tackling that he's done very well there in Iowa.
Tim, I think another factor is that there is a fundamental decision that has not been made about Hillary Clinton among Iowans. You have undecided Iowans, as you were saying a minute ago, at 49%, and they don't want to get it wrong this time. And I talked to Democrats out there, they feel like they got it wrong with John Kerry, and so she hasn't closed that deal. The race is static. It hasn't moved in several months, which seems important.
Michelle Norris, you're in Des Moines. You were a moderator of the Brown and Black caucus last night, forum last night. Tell us what happened. There you are on the screen asking a question of the Democratic candidates, one of whom I think is Chris Dodd. There he is. Tell us what happened last night. All of us were watching college football.
Well, it was actually probably weren't able to get it, depending on where you were. But what was interesting, the hallmark of the Brown and Black Forum is that the candidates are able to actually pose a question to another candidate. Each of them had an opportunity to do that. And what was interesting is only a few of the candidates used that to try to land a punch. I mean, most of them were lobbing softballs, easy questions. In one case, Dennis Kucinich, who felt that he wasn't getting enough time, posed a question to himself to make sure that he had enough time to speak to the audience. So what I read in that is that candidates with a race that is so close right now that seem to be playing it safe going into these last weeks. They're willing to make attacks in some cases, but on the stage last night, they missed an opportunity. I just want to reach back to something that Gene said, though, about inevitability, now that I've spent some time here in Iowa. That's a word that a lot of people that I've talked to here do not like. Iowans take very seriously the role that they play in the early voting process. They take these caucuses very seriously. And the sense that Hillary Clinton was the inevitable candidate did not go down easy with a lot of voters that I spoke with. They don't want to be told that their votes don't count. They want to know that they have, that they play an important role in this process.
Most interesting. Let me show you New Hampshire. After Iowa comes New Hampshire, January 8th. And here's the latest numbers from New Hampshire. Barack Obama in the Fox News opinion poll is at 23. Hillary Clinton is at 30. John Edwards, 17. Bill Richardson, 17. In the Suffolk University, it's Clinton, 34. Obama, 22. Edwards, 15. Richardson, 9. Hillary Clinton hopes to make that her firewall at any kind. If she loses Iowa, try to rebound in New Hampshire. If not, what happens on the South Carolina? And look at these numbers. Clinton 19, Obama 17, Edwards 12, Richardson 1, undecided 49. Clinton is down 7 from August. Some of the other candidates are up a bit, but the undecideds have gone up from 35 to 49. And look at African Americans. They will account for half of the turnout at the in the primary in South Carolina. Obama is now in the lead at 25, Clinton 21, Edwards 3, don't know, 50%. Mm-hmm. The favorite son of Orangeburg, South Carolina. Tell us what's going on.
No, people are taking another look at the race. The kind of initial reaction was Clinton. We know the Clintons. There are questions about whether an African-American can really win the presidency. Can Barack Obama really win? Come on now. And who is he anyway? What does this guy have? And now that, you know, Obama has been around, he is doing well in Iowa, leading in Iowa, people are taking another look at the race and saying, well, hold on there.
Are you suggesting if Obama won Iowa, and because independents in New Hampshire decided to involve themselves in the Democratic primary, and he happened to win New Hampshire, he would then go into South Carolina, and black voters would say, this may be a potential president, and we're more willing to embrace him?
Well, I've always thought that Obama would do better in South Carolina than those early polls were suggesting, because my sense of people down there, just anecdotally, was there was a real willingness to take a look at him, a fondness for him and admiration for him, but questions about electability and also the experience question.
But if he lost Iowa and New Hampshire?
If he lost Iowa and New Hampshire, why not go with Hillary Clinton? But if he won Iowa and New Hampshire, I would bet he wins South Carolina.
I also think there's a dynamic here. You know, all these Republicans go out and talk about that Hillary Clinton is the shoe-in, and then they all pile on her in a debate context or out on the campaign trail. I think in some ways that hurts her in this regard. I think a lot of Democrats see that, and they're reminded of the fact that how polarizing she is, and that these Republicans know how to run against her. They look at a Barack Obama and they say, wow, he really is new on the scene. He might be a little tougher to contend with. I think that has some impact on people thinking, is she really the one?
Also in South Carolina, two other issues, faith. You know, if South Carolina, all of a sudden now Barack Obama is going to make the church circuit run, you're going to see that. We haven't really talked so much yet about Oprah, but here comes Oprah, yeah. December 8th and 9th down into Columbia. I mean, there are two major intangibles right there.
I want to get to that. Let's talk about things that you cannot predict that can happen in any campaign. It's a long 5 weeks away. Look on Friday in New Hampshire, in Rochester, New Hampshire. This man went into Hillary Clinton's headquarters. There he is taking off some, thank God, fake explosives, surrendering to police. Senator Clinton monitored the situation, flew to New Hampshire that night, and made these comments.
I also want to thank all of law enforcement. We were in touch from the moment this began with local, county, state, federal law enforcement. And I am so grateful to them for their response, which brought this hostage situation to such a good ending.
Senator Clinton trying to show strength and experience in a difficult situation. That same morning, Friday morning, where was Barack Obama? Having breakfast with Mayor Mike Bloomberg, an independent, thinking about running for president. Obama trying to suggest change. Independence. Right. The campaign being played out before our very eyes on events that really are beyond the control of voters.
And you know, this is what's so important. I think these moments that are spontaneous, that are unscripted. So something horrible happens to the Clinton campaign, and it does, it showcases her ability to show strength, to act presidential, to act as a president would in a crisis, and how she handles that. And Barack Obama, again, playing to his strengths. He understands that Mike Bloomberg is a power center for independent voters and ideas.
You mentioned David Brody, Oprah Winfrey. Here is Oprah Winfrey greeting Barack Obama on her show in October. He called her then his girl. She has now agreed to go to Iowa, New Hampshire, South Carolina. Michelle Norris, what's your sense? Does the celebrity of Oprah Winfrey translate into political support for Barack Obama?
Well, you've got two celebrities at work here. You've got Hillary Clinton's husband, Bill Clinton, last night at the Brown Black Forum, when he entered the hall, it was like a rock star had walked into the auditorium.